Blackstone Audio presents The Chemical Wedding by Christian Rosencreutz, A Romance in 8 Days by Johann Valentin Andreä, in a new version by John Crowley. This book is read by John Crowley. Introduction. 1. The Chemical Wedding by Christian Rosencreutz is the way I've decided to present the title of this book. Most versions in English are called The Chemical Wedding of Christian Rosencreutz, which suggests, and most people who've heard of it suppose, that the wedding is Christian's. It's not. Christian Rosencreutz is the purported author of a book called The Chemical Wedding. The actual author is Johann Valentin Andreä, whose name didn't appear on the book originally, thus ensuring the confusion. I'll call it herein, as everyone mostly does, simply The Chemical Wedding. Though its original readers would have had a certain amount of context for the truly bizarre and surprising events it tells of, it's possible that The Chemical Wedding is now more enjoyable without knowing that context and experiencing the book unmediated. Consider a similar case, a little book published in 1934 by the surrealist artist Max Ernst, called Une Semaine de Bonté. It was made entirely of collaged illustrations cut out of old books. Ernst can be said to have invented this now common art medium, actually. And the resulting dream scenes, seeming to propose a narrative that's actually impossible to discover, are wonderfully mysterious and compelling. You certainly don't need to know that Ernst may have plotted the whole thing according to the principles of ancient alchemy and alchemical practice. In fact, to me at least, knowing that it has such a unifying subtext makes it somehow less interesting, not more. The Chemical Wedding is also based on or connected to alchemy and alchemical practice, and may even be a parody of such practice, which was taken very seriously when the book appeared. If you have a particular interest in decoding texts along those lines, you may want to investigate those connections. But even if you investigate assiduously, The Chemical Wedding will puzzle and may occasionally annoy you with its irreducible strangeness. Read simply as a story, however, whatever its meaning, if any, is perfectly easy to follow and very readable. Sometimes it's very funny. And the allegorical or symbolic or political or theological explanations that have been offered can't really account for all that happens in it anyway. My aim in producing this new version was simply to make this, one of the great outlandish stories in Western literature, accessible to readers in the context of no context. 2. The Chemical Wedding by Christian Rosencreutz was published in Germany in 1616, though it probably circulated in manuscript for some time before that. It was presented as the work of a person named Christian Rosencreutz, or Christian of the Rose Cross, a mysterious magus who died at the age of 106 in 1484, after a lifetime of traveling the world, being inducted into the wisdom societies of several lands, and forming his own secret society of wise brothers. Ever since, these brothers of the Rose Cross have gone about the world healing illness and doing good without our recognizing their presence among us. That, at any rate, was the story told of him in 2 pamphlets that appeared, also without an author, just before The Chemical Wedding was published. The pamphlets demanded or promised a universal reformation, announced that human knowledge was about to take a vast leap forward, and predicted the fall of many states and kingdoms. These little books, plus The Chemical Wedding, which is a very different affair, became the foundation of what has ever after been known as the Rosicrucian phenomenon, or movement, or scare, or hoax. The ancient and mystical order of the Rose Cross, or Rosicrucian order, is a modern fraternity founded in 1915 and related only in name to the older one. Even today, it's unclear how these texts came to be, who wrote them, what they intended, and whether there ever really was a mystic brotherhood at all. Probably not. It's clear that segments of the society in which they first appeared were very ready to hear what they had to say, insofar as that could be divined, and others felt very threatened by them. Furious debates about religion were underway in the midst of war and the threat of war between states with different Christian religious establishments. The witch hysteria was intensifying, and there were signs that the world might be coming to an end, or maybe that a new world was about to dawn. So it was a moment for a craze.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.